From the historic Loretto Abbey Chapel, with the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents the Daily TV Mass.
Welcome to the celebration of the Daily TV Mass. My name is Father Hank Van Myl. The televising of this Mass is made possible by the contribution of two donors. The first is Pia Maria D'Amico from Quint West, Ontario, in memory of her loving husband Elio D'Amico on the first anniversary of his passing. The second are Drs. Albert and Aurora Mariani from Honolulu, Hawaii, in thanksgiving for blessings received and for the intentions of the Daily TV Mass community, or thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you. And again, as we have placed ourselves before the Lord, realizing that every breath belongs to God, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. And let us pray. O God, from whom all good things come, grant that we, who call on you in our need, may at your prompting discern what is right, and by your guidance do it. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. King Ahab summoned all the Israelites and assembled the prophets of Baal at Mount Carmel. Elijah then came near to all the people and said, "How long will you go limping with two different opinions? If the Lord is God, follow him, but if Baal, then follow him." The people did not answer him a word. Then Elijah said to the people, I only, am left a prophet of the Lord, but Baal's prophets number 450. Let two bulls be given to us. Let them choose one bull for themselves, cut it in pieces, and lay it on the wood, but put no fire to it. I will prepare the other bull and lay it on the wood, but put no fire to it. Then you call on the name of your God, and I will call on the name of the Lord. The God who answers by fire is indeed God. All the people answered, "Well spoken." Then Elisha said to the prophets of Baal, "Choose for yourselves one bull and prepare it first, for you are many. Then call on the name of your God, but put no fire to it." So they took the bull that was given them, prepared it, and called on the name of Baal from morning until noon, crying, "O Baal, answer us." But there was no voice and no answer. They limped about the altar that they had made. At noon, Elisha mocked them, saying, "Cry aloud, surely he is a god. Either he is meditating, or he has wandered away, or he is on a journey, or perhaps he is asleep and must be awakened." Then they cried aloud, and, as was their custom, they cut themselves with swords and lances until the blood gushed out over them. As midday passed, they raved on until the time of the offering of the oblation, but there was no voice, no answer, and no response. Then Elisha said to all the people, "Come closer to me." And all the people came closer to him. First, he repaired the altar of the Lord that had been thrown down. Elisha took 12 stones, according to the number of the tribes of the sons of Jacob, to whom the word of the Lord came, saying, "Israel shall be your name." With the stones he built an altar in the name of the Lord. Then he made a trench around the altar, large enough to contain 2 measures of seed. Next, he put the wood in order, cut the bull in pieces, and laid it on the wood. He said, "Fill 4 jars with water and pour it on the burnt offering and on the wood." Then he said, "Do it a second time." And they did it a second time. Again, he said, "Do it a third time." And they did it a third time. so that the water ran all around the altar and filled the trench also with water. At the time of the offering of the oblation, the prophet Elisha came near and said, O Lord, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, let it be known this day that you are God in Israel, that I am your servant, and that I have done all these things at your bidding. Answer me, O Lord, answer me, so that this people may know that you are, O Lord, our God, and that you have turned their hearts back. Then the fire of the Lord fell and consumed the burnt offering, the wood, the stones, and the dust, and even licked up the water that was in the trench. When all the people saw it, they fell on their faces and said, The Lord indeed is God. The Lord indeed is God. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, Do not think that I have come to abolish the law of the prophets. I've come not to abolish it, but to fulfill. For truly I tell you, until heaven and earth pass away, not one letter, not one stroke of a letter will pass from the law until all is accomplished. Therefore, whoever breaks one of the least of these commandments and teaches others to do the same will be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But whoever does them and teaches them, we will be called great in the kingdom of heaven. The Gospel of the Lord. Naturally, if we take our Gospel reading literally, then no one of us ever will enter heaven. And well, obviously, also, we cannot enter heaven without the mercy of God, and we all need that mercy. As I reflected on today's readings, I kept every time coming back to Psalm 16, right there in the middle. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. Keep me safe, O God, you are my hope. Psalm 16 is a psalm of faith and hope, trust. In as we feel lonely or persecuted or whatever, it's a psalm of hope. And it's beautiful to pray with, especially when we're lonely or we feel abandoned or life is just difficult. And that's a human story. Life can be difficult. And in the first reading from 1 Kings, we have Elijah in the northern kingdom. He's the only one left, only prophet left, who follows the God of Israel. And there's 450 other prophets, and it sounds a little bit like our own contemporary society. There's all kinds of teachings about good living and how we should live and what we should eat and whatever, and what kind of exercises we should do and so on. And all kinds of philosophies of how following God. And to live the Christian life can be very lonely. I have a feeling that as you watch this TV mass, that many in our TV mass community feel lonely, feel abandoned, like Elijah among the 450 prophets who were teaching something else. Loneliness can even be found in a marriage, in a family. We can be lonely as we try to live out a Christian life among people who in the secular world who do different things. We can be so lonely, especially later on in life, as we end up in a nursing home and we kind of feel abandoned by family. There's so many ways to feel lonely, to feel abandoned, that, and especially when that time comes, that it's also an opportunity to grow in God, in the love of God. Because when we are lonely, there's only one thing left, God. God who infinitely loves us, no matter what. And so, when we go to our second reading, or sorry, the gospel, it's part of the Sermon of the Mount. And as I said, you know, it's a little bit literal, the letter of the law. But the Sermon of the Mount in Matthew is beautiful. Blessed, just verse 11, just a little bit before today's reading, it says, blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. When we feel persecuted, when we feel lonely, and persecution is not something in war zones or so ever. It is so much found in our daily living, where we feel so lonely or persecuted for our faith. And you know, well, we all know what we, you know, your Miss Goody shoes, or oh, you're trying to be so holy, or whatever it is. Blessed are you. Blessed are you. Blessed are you when people reveal you. Good stuff to pray with in combination with Psalm 116. And we have, our history is so filled with loneliness and abandonedness. And so often, and that's why also the martyrs are often a good example. Today on the universal calendar, we remember the martyrs of La Rochelle. During the French Revolution, they had 827 priests and religious, vowed religious, so sisters and brothers. They put them on abandoned ships, ships which were not seaworthy. 542 died from starvation, disease, lack of sanitation. Reason? They did not sign on to the French Constitution at that time. They said, no, we are Roman Catholic. We belong to Rome. The Pope is our leader. And for that, they were imprisoned and put in very deplorable conditions. But from the survivors, those who survived, about 300, they came back with all kinds of testimonies of the deep, deep faith of so many who had passed away on those ships, abandoned by society. But God was there. And when they were starving and disease, lack of water, there was a strength in them. The strength which gave strength to the survivors. We have the testimonies. And so this is for us too. When we feel lonely or abandoned, wherever we are, to be quiet, to listen in our heart, and let God speak to our heart, to that strength which society cannot teach us, which our world cannot give us. Doesn't matter how much money we have. In the silence of our hearts, God will give us strength. Amen. And so let us bring our prayers before the Lord. And we pray for all those in our daily TV Mass community who have asked to be included in our prayer intention book, especially those who are facing significant transitions in their activities, health, relationships, or finances. We pray to the Lord. We pray for the souls in purgatory as they are not yet in full union with God. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all the elderly abandoned by their families. Fill them with peace of heart and grant them the companionship of others in their loneliness. We pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the gift of years granted in our time to so many men and women in the second half of life. We thank you for the presence in our community, for their life experience, their courage and wisdom, their witness of faith. We ask your blessing upon them as they live the many transitions that are part of maturing years. Be with them. Keep them in your care. Grant them peace and enable them to be beacons of hope in our world. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquities. Cleanse me of my sins. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Praise and the glory of God's name for our good and the good of all his holy church. Look kindly upon our service, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer may be acceptable, an acceptable oblation to you, and lead us to grow in charity through Christ, O Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for just as through your beloved Son you created the human race, so also through him, with great goodness, you formed it anew. And so it is right that all your creatures serve you, all the redeemed praise you, and all your saints with one heart bless you. Therefore, we too extol you with all the angels, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving you thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, the Canadian bishops, the clergy, and the entire people you have called your own. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. And at the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. Amen." The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us offer each other a sign of peace. The Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. And may the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life. May the blood of Christ keep me safe.
With those of you at home, join with me now in this act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though you were already there, I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Permit not that I should ever be separated from you. Amen.
And let us pray. May your healing work, O God, Lord, free us, we pray, from doing evil and lead us to what is right, through Christ, O Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God.
Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass. Please remember that all requests for prayers are included in our Prayer Intentions book and shared with all of our celebrants.